I'm going to show you how to plan many activities for many people in Excel. This plan was created for an elementary school teacher who had 20 students and had 20 activities that they needed to complete in a week. Each day is broken down into 5 time slots, and in each time slot they're able to complete one activity. Now on sheet 2, I have I've referred to each student as C1 to C20, and you could put I've got Mickey Mouse here, but you can put the student's name next to the C that they're responsible for. Okay, so let's go back to sheet 1. Now the other thing that they wanted to be able to have some stations closed. So I'm going to put an X so that we know that that station isn't available that day. And now let's put another X here. And I'm just going to drag that across. So now let's run the code. And you can see now that every student does every single station all the way until the end of Friday, and then we have every and then on the days where the stations are closed, it just simply skips over those that are closed. And so there you have your 20 students completing 20 activities within a week, and you still have a few time slots left at the end here. So let's look at the code. I will of course include the code in the description of my video. So what I've done here is I have called it if is empty, and then I have declared a bunch of values as integers. So R for a row, C for a column, I for is a student number, and count is what I'll explain as we go. And right now the count is 0. And so what we're doing is we're not adjusting this at all, but on the second one we'll be going down one, so that you can see on the second one that it's not in the first row, it's the second row that it starts in. So for the first half of this we go worksheets equals RC, which is 4, 3 to start with, and then we go for the row, we go row 4 to 24, which is the bottom, minus count. We have an if statement. If activity value equals, if it's empty, then it's C plus 1, which is the I for the student, and then we go I plus 1, and activity cell offset, so we're going to go down one row. But if it is full, then it's going to just skip over it, and then it's going to keep going like this for the whole thing until it gets to 24 minus count. Now if there is students that are left that we haven't reached the 20, then what it's going to do is it's going to go up to the top and continue the list down and blank out the sheet. And what we will do is we'll F8 through this so you can see it happening. And so let's start F8ing through this. Now I'm going to go for the first part quickly here. And so the count is at 1, and so it starts on the second line there. And let's continue down. So this one, there'll be no adjustments because it reached its 20. But here, it's going to go back to the top and put in the 20 that wasn't put on the bottom. So that's how you fill out the chart for 20 people for 20 activities in a week. I will include the code in the description of my video. Please subscribe.